I believe that we in Ukraine faced the problem with the lack of trust to whole institution and whole parties. And according to the research, the main institute which have this trust from the society is the army, actually. So this is the main issues, and that's why I believe so crucial to have the politician who can receive the trust from the society. But now we have that on the top, the army, second the NGOs. So that's why Mr. Svoboda said that politicians should grant it on the NGOs support. You asked about radicalization, yes? I believe that this is the fifth year of the conflict. I believe the radicalization is not the something which needs for Ukrainian, because we are so tired from the war and from the conflict that they want, people want to have a peace. So basically, as Nadia said during the discussion, over the 70% of population are ready to the compromise. I want to end the conflict, and that's why not the radicalization, but the peace and compromise is the way. But it's another story that nobody reached the compromise without, any circumstances. So basically, people want to have compromise, but a low compromise, not to have very strong bottom line. This is the Crimea is Ukraine, and the Donbas is the part of Ukraine. So without any exclusion for any part of Ukraine. Civil society, after the Maidan, after Revolution of Dignity, civil societies, NGOs, special organizations, they supported the reforms, the institutions, and many from civil society activists came to the institution just to rebuild it. And the main heroes of, post-Maidan authorities is a civil society representative who came into the authorities, into the power, just in order to change the system from the inside. Basically, now civil institutions and NGOs are strong supported by the reform, but on the other hand, the NGOs became a target from the perspective from the side of politicians, because NGOs became too strong in some situations, for example with anti-corruption and anti-corruption system, and the different organization has received the support from the USA and different donors. I became the player on this field and with the fight of corruption. So basically, at some moment, the anti-corruption activists who used to play a main role in this, build of the anti-corruption system, they became not very pleasant for the government. And that's why anti-corruption activists, for example, they are the target for the power, for the authority. And that's why some attacks for the anti-corruption activists is stayed, 2 years ago, and now they are not in safe. So I believe that NGOs and civil societies can play a huge role in the rebuild of institution and build of trust of this institution. But on the other hand, we have elite, we have oligarch system, which are strongly resistant against NGOs who are, unpredictable for them as a partner. I believe I'm not content conducted the monitoring, but I believe that all candidates use this technology in their pre-election campaign because of the lack because of lack of the responsibility for this type of violations. So basically, we do not have any, you know, legal responsibility for the fake news, for this, let's say, exaggeration of their power, of their possibility, of their illusion, you know, about Ukraine. So that's why not just Poroshenko used this technology, and all top candidates usually use. But I want to highlight that in this pre-election and election campaign, we have additional proof that who can achieve or reach the TV channel. So the person who can do it, those candidates can reach the people, because the main sources of information for the whole population of Ukraine is TV, and basically this is the main milestone for this company. And I believe that each candidate create the myths about themselves, but you know, the actual president has many stuff which he can grant it to his polling campaign, voting campaign, which have been done not by him only, but for many people who work with him and after Maidan revolution. And this is tricky issues for other candidates who haven't have such resource to say that I'm an army, I'm the defender of the Ukraine, I'm the reformer, I'm the visa campaign. So basically, I believe so. In this voting campaign, Petro Poroshenko used this information about something good which have been done in Ukraine during these 5 years. Mm-hmm. And this is his resource, actually.